Yo, what's going on, everyone? Chris Manor back bringing you guys another video today. And today, I gotta make a rant video on Halo Infinite. I've been going through this. I've been doing a lot of single player games. I like to play multiplayer games. Okay, man, like, so I'm trying to like, I have like these personal goals. You know, I like to hit max rank in as many multiplayer games. Not max rank, but like a really high rank. In Valorant, I was able to hit fucking like Immortal. This is before it meant absolutely nothing, I guess. Apparently now it means nothing. Maybe I'll play Valorant next. In Halo, I hit Onyx. I haven't played CS. I could try playing CS. I don't know. But Dota, I hit Divine, which is not Immortal. Maybe that's another game I consider. Anyway, like, I like to try and hit the highest rank, you know, because it's a fun challenge for me, right? So I hit Onyx in Season 1, and I was really proud of myself. And I was like, hell yeah, that's sick. So I had similar goals here in Season 2. Halo Infinite has the worst ranked game mode out of any game I think I've ever played. That's not an exaggeration either. I've actually thought about this for quite a while, and I've had a lot of time to think about it because the queue is so long for this fucking game because nobody plays it. So I want to make this very clear. I'm talking strictly about the ranked experience here in Halo Infinite and why this game's multiplayer fucking sucks. Okay, so when I say this game's multiplayer fucking sucks, I'm talking strictly about the ranked experience, okay? And it's even more painful because I actually think the core multiplayer is really good. But I think that Halo, as a complete product, is really driven by competition, okay? Competitive Halo, I think, is what... When you think of Halo, you think of, like, competition, okay? And 343, I don't know what the fuck they're doing, all right? But, man, these guys are really blowing it, like, because they've got a really good game here, okay? And they're just, nobody plays it. There's no reason to play ranked. That's one of the things we'll talk about. So first off, this is a minor complaint, but there's a countdown timer to queuing. I want to ask someone at 343, hey guys, when you type in a URL in a website and you click enter, you think it has a countdown timer to when you actually go to the website? No, because that's fucking stupid. Okay, it just sends you to the website. So why is it when I play your game and I click queue ranked or queue any game mode, it says 3, 2, 1. Okay, now you're queuing. Like, what? Why? Why? Who's the person? I don't like to call for people's jobs, okay? Yes, I do, actually. Who the fuck am I lying to? I love calling for people's jobs. The person who came up with this idea, they needed to never work on video games again, okay? Take this guy, move him to the janitorial department, okay? Have him clean the building, all right? Because this guy's fucking got terrible ideas. That needs to be removed from the game immediately, and I believe that's across all game modes. Okay, now I'm talking about rank shit. So first off, the queues for this game. I have never seen a game pop up where it has more messages that say, you should stop queuing this game mode because nobody's playing it. I've been playing this game for probably the past couple days, probably a total of like 5 hours over 2 days. I've seen this message pop up at least 6 times. No, that's selling it short. Probably 10 times. If you don't believe me, you can go through my streams. I stream both on YouTube and on Twitch. You can go through the VODs there and just kind of skim through them and see how many times I can see these messages pop up. It's absurd. Okay? So the queue times are just ridiculous. And that's not necessarily 343's fault. Well, it kind of is because there's literally no incentive to play ranked. Okay? Which I guess that'll lead to my next point. There's no incentive to play ranked. You get like a sticker. You get a little gun buddy that hangs off your fucking gun. Okay? I don't even know if you get that for each season or if you get that for like, you know, just a one-time unlock. I don't know how that works. Okay? I hit Onyx in Season 1. I did not hit Onyx in Season 2 because the queue times are just so long. I can't even find matches. I cannot find games. I'm sitting in queue waiting and waiting and waiting. I'm trying in the middle of the afternoon. I'm trying late at night NA times. I'm trying evening times NA. Like, I can't find games. I'm not gonna try mornings because God forbid gamers don't fucking get up in the morning. And get this, when I do finally get games, the quality of these games are so bad. It's hilarious how bad the quality of these matches are, okay? First off, what is one common thing? There's two common things pretty much in every competitive like game mode you play across like any game. It's don't grief matches, right? Try and take it serious. You know, or at least try. And don't leave matches, okay? If you leave the match, you're gonna get punished. This is pretty standard across like every ranked experience I've ever been across. I've been across a lot of them. Counter-Strike, Dota, League, Halo, Valorant. Jesus, what else is there? TFT, fucking, like, any of these other games. Any game that has a ranked game. It's like, yo, you probably shouldn't just be leaving the game, okay? Like, put the fucking game. In Halo Infinite, there is no punishment for leaving the game. And I know this because I rage quit a game once. It was definitely out of rage. Not gonna act like it wasn't. But it was also the kind of scene in the back of my head. Like, I wonder if there's anything that happens when you leave a game. You get any kind of warning or any kind? Nothing. Nothing. Leaving a ranked game in Halo Infinite is exactly like leaving a regular game in Halo Infinite, which is fucking stupid. That should never be the case, ever. This is ranked. It's supposed to be taken kind of a little more serious, okay? It's supposed to be. So what happens is in about 50%, I would argue this, in about 50% of the games, all the games I've played, there must have been people, every game, was just somebody on my team leaving or somebody on their team leaving. It felt like 50%. It was probably closer to like 30 or 40, realistically. But that's still an absurdly high number. Look, they got a guy who's AFK on their team. In this gameplay I'm recording. I picked this gameplay because I'm like, oh, okay, this looks like a game I got good stats on. This happens every fucking game, it seems like. It's insane. I don't know how there's no punishment for not leaving a ranked game or being AFK. But there isn't. Hey. Cool, I guess. I don't know if that's the decision you want to go with. One of the reasons people don't queue as well, there's no fucking new content. They added in one new map. That's a problem with live service games. That's a problem with this game in general, though. But, like, there's also just no incentive to play ranked. You don't get anything really cool. So, that's stupid. Like I said, a lot of people, when they think of Halo, it's competition. Everyone loves playing in close competitive matches. Everyone loves doing that. So, fuel that, 343. Don't fucking add incentives, add rewards for people who do well in matches. There's no reward. If you do well in a match, there is no reward for doing well in a match when it comes to Battle Pass. Now, that's an overall progression system issue. I get that. But, like, that's insane. Imagine playing a game and a guy who goes 30-3 gets the same amount of reward as a guy who goes 3-30. I can say, oh, well, they don't get as much ELO gain. Yeah, but in towards the contribution to the Battle Pass, same. Plus whatever your play a match reward was for the day. It's stupid. That's stupid. No other game is like this. All right, let's backtrack a little bit because I'm skipping all over my notes here because it's late as night and I'm tilted as fuck. Let's say you finally get into a match, okay? You've been queued for like 10-15 minutes. You've clicked through the fucking messages to say, hey, don't queue, motherfucker, this game is dead. You know, and you're like, fuck that shit, I'm gonna queue because I want to play the game because I want to hit my Onyx rank. You're like me. And I salute you, sir. I salute your dedication. So you finally do all that, right? How's the match itself? And so outside of the leavers, okay? Let's say there's nobody who's leaving. This is also just the worst matchmaking I've ever played in any game. I've never played a ranked game that has the worst players in it, in the game, statistically, like rank-wise, get paired up against the best players, rank-wise, in the game. I've seen this happen at least three times. At least three separate games where this has happened. Where I'll get bronze players matching up against Onyxes. And these motherfuckers will go like 3-30. Now, it's not their fault. They're bad at the game. Why are they being queued into this, though? I saw one guy today. We were playing a game. We were owning, dude. We were up big. And this motherfucker quit because he was 0-10. He just quit right out. It's like, dude, how... And then we lose a 3v4 because, you know, we can't fucking find anybody. I'm going to have to fast forward here in my VOD because, you know, it's just going to be me queuing probably. Or it's going to be insta-queue. Sometimes that happens. I mean, I'm checking the ranks after every game to see, like, what rank people are and stuff. Yeah, this team is horribly imbalanced against, you know, against them. So you get just completely one-sided games, okay, in terms of ELO. It seems like rank does not matter at all, okay? There's no ranked. It's a ranked game mode, but ranked is not a factor at all. Am I fucking even queuing? What the fuck's happening? Okay, so we're fast forwarding here. The last game finished up at... So this looks like it's a 8-minute queue. That's not too bad. That's not too bad at all. That's pretty bad. 8 minutes is a long time. So the teams are horribly balanced. You probably got people, somebody's gonna leave, okay? Because there's no punishment for people not leaving. And get this, and get this. Sometimes it doesn't even put you on the fucking right servers. I shit you not. I was playing today, I got put in a European server. Why? Why? What happened? Did I queue for Europe? Hell no, I didn't queue for Europe. It just put me in there. I don't know why. I've had ranked games. This was last act. This was actually what broke the camel's back, which is a saying, quote unquote. Last time I played in Australia or fucking Asian servers, I had 200 ping. Like, dude, I want to enjoy this game. I really do. I think the core gameplay is so much fun. I think the competition of Halo is fucking a blast. There's all these other factors. There's all these other factors that are just shitting on the game. Long queue times. Bad fucking pings to certain servers. Didn't even get me started on the inconsistencies of, like, the actual core gameplay. Like, sometimes I'm fucking just swinging an enemy, and my melee will just, like, they'll be on my screen, but I'll swing, and it'll, like, miss them. Somehow. They'll be, like, right in front of me, and I'll swing, and it'll miss, and then they'll, like, kill me. And it's like, okay. I've had that happen a whole bunch this season. And maybe that's just me being fucking terrible at the game. But I don't think it is, okay? I don't think it's that bad. I don't think I'm that bad. I think I'm pressing melee and I'm swinging that I should be hitting these people. Okay? I think that should be happening. In conclusion, man, I hope 343 fixes this game. If you're somebody who likes Halo, do not bother to play ranked on PC. I need to clarify this is all being done on PC because I don't think there's a crossplay between Xbox and PC. I think it seems like they've removed that option. And I know because I tried searching and it was like, you must plug a controller to have this function. I was like, oh, okay, well, that's really fucking stupid. So that was my experience. If I'm doing something wrong, feel free to criticize me. But as of now, man, I'm done with this game. I don't recommend anyone play Halo Infinite Ranked. That sucks because Halo is like a staple of fucking video games. And the fact that this game's competitive scene is just garbage and the company that's manifesting this is no fucking clue what they're doing whatsoever. I don't know. Stay away from this game, man. 343, you guys need to fucking fix this shit. This game is, you got a good game here. You worked really hard on the core gameplay. That's obvious. Now you need to add in the other shit, and it seems like you're not doing that and you don't have any interest in doing that. Anyway, I'll thank you guys for watching. I'll see you guys in the next one. I'm out. Peace.